That was our neighbour, but he didn't know me, I'm sure. He didn't even know I had a bike, that fella. Some of them know and some don't. I don't keep it in, out in sight. I can see some second cut down over there at, well, I can't think of the name, Percy Rig anyway. I know the name though. Anyway, we're thoroughly into autumn now, because this, later this week is the first sheep sale. And I'll probably be going to that, that's that fellow who does the field walk in there. There's a red sign there, but it doesn't say the road's closed. What's it say? Oh, road works. That's really cold, the ditch. That's Whorlton Castle and there's no one there. But, oh, I'd say I wanted to look at this church thing along here, which I've never looked at before. And there is somebody there, but it looks like it's just going. There's a roof. Well, see, the church now is in the village. There's still a kind of a chapel type thing, which is presumably for when they bring coffins there or something. This is Whorlton. Oh, I never see it really. W-H-O-R-L, Whorlton. Church, old church. Because Whorlton isn't really a village anymore. It seemed like Swainby more or less took over, and this is Whorlton Castle. I've just noticed a sudden resurgence of interest, if that's a word, resurgence. Because I had taken some video of it years ago, 2014. And suddenly people are looking at it again because there's been a bit of silly interest in it to do with holding seances, but not in the main castle part. There's a sort of a crypt thing at the back.
Here we have Whorlton Castle, and I'm sitting on the undercroft, which I've never really looked at before. There's more of it left than I thought. Over there, there's a very large stone trough. I'm amazed someone hasn't got that out for a garden or something. I'd have to get it through the castle. It was quite a feat. But it is really quite an abused castle, because there's no charge or entry to come in. It's privately owned, but they're not that fussed, I think. And everywhere you go, there's tins and bottles thrown about, and you have to just be a bit careful because they've been having a shit in the cubbyhole things and that. But I must admit, I think before that left-hand doorway must have had a door on it, because you couldn't go in. There's actually a spiral staircase in there. You can go up to the first floor, but there's not much to see really. That's only the gatehouse. The actual castle is here behind. This kind of circular area is defensible. I'm not sure whether there was like a keep in the middle or what. There's certainly a bump there. Some other buildings. It would be interesting to have had that excavated, wouldn't it? That sort of mound, but it could just be rubble. There's been probably been a perimeter wall, and there's quite a steep bank, and that's one on that side, and they've dug a ditch on the other side.
I had the drone going and the GoPro, and got some very close-up footage of the walls and interior. But it is windy here, and as soon as you rose up inside, just to get to the top, it was quite alarming how the wind would take it, because it was so sort of sudden and gusty. If you're like in a more constant wind, it's not so bad. You have some funny old second cut up there, and they're baling it in big square bales. It's a bit of a culture shock, it's really come out on a road like this. I forgot the actual go on the dual carriageway for about a mile. And then straight off at the North Allerton turn, and then a left before it dives back under the road or something.